It is now 12 years since the UPDF sent troops to Somalia under the African Union mission. The fruits of the UPDF deployment are manifested in the improved security around the capital Mogadishu.
Progress has been made, and those of you who have not been to Somalia before, you will find that Mogadishu is a fast-growing port city.
We've been on the offensive, and it continues, in the lower Shabelle area. We believe if we degrade the Al-Shabaab, protect the population, then we can allow development and peace to happen.
Before the AMISOM deployment and UPDF taking over security around the capital, Mogadishu was practically a war zone, with the sound of explosions and machine gun fire being part of the daily life. According to the AMISOM deputy commander in charge of operations and plans, Lieutenant General James Nakibes Lakara, the biggest threat to their operations are the improvised explosives used by the Al-Shabaab after the group suffered heavy defeats in open combat.
Now what we have done is to initiate counter-ID measures, to include equipment provision for detection, but more often than not, because of the level of the kind of expertise that Al-Shabaab has, including foreign fighters.
Al-Shabaab, they've run out of options. Their preferred weapon of choice is small IEDs, which they put on magnets and put on vehicles, from the huge VBIDs where they would drive a vehicle into a hotel and attack. We have not seen that. Then suicide bombings.
However, the Al-Shabaab militias still control some parts of central Somalia.
Al-Shabaab runs the tax system. Over the last year alone, in the lower Shabelle area, they made $21 million. In Mogadishu, 30. They even tax in Mogadishu. They call, they say, you brought in two containers of this, pay so much.
According to the Somalia Transition Plan, AMISOM forces are expected to hand over to the Somali government forces by 2021.
AMISOM is not intending to leave. AMISOM is compelled to leave.
So far, the SNA has built, since January, they have generated 6 fighting battalions. This is unprecedented. We are mentoring them, and what we do, we capture towns together, and they hold.
Whereas efforts for a unity government are in high gear, clan differences among the political leaders have made it even harder to realize. Ali Mivule, NTV Somalia.